Whenever a transmission is performed, it is susceptible to interception. Retailers have solved part of the problem by using encryption techniques to secure transactions dealing with the credit card numbers and other private information. Businesses that want their employees to access the corporate computing system from a remote site have found a similar solution. VPN, virtual private network. A VPN is a data network connection that makes use of the public telephone communication, the public telecommunication infrastructure, like the internet connection, but maintains privacy through the use of a tunneling protocol and security procedures. A tunneling protocol, so it maintains security. A tunneling protocol such as point-to-point tunneling, PPTP tunneling protocol, is the command set that allows an organization to create a secure connection using public resources such as internet. Proposed by Cisco Systems, PPTP is a standard sponsored by Microsoft and other companies. It is an extension of the internet's point-to-point protocol, PPP. All right, which is used for communication between two computers using the serial, using a serial connection. The most common example of serial connection is DSL or cable modem connection between users, workstation, and the internet service provider. PPP is usually the standard preferred over an earlier protocol, the serial line internet protocol, or SLIP. Employees who are located outside the company building uses PPTP to create a tunnel through the internet into the corporate computing resources. Because this connection runs over the internet and may be used to transmit confidential corporate data, it must be secured. The security of the connection is often supported by IPsec. IPsec or IP security is IPsec is an abbreviation, or IP security is a set of protocols developed by the Internet Engineering Task Force to support the secure exchange of data packets at the IP layer. IPsec. In order for the IPsec to work, both sender and receiver must exchange public encryption keys. Public encryption keys. All right. Besides being a secure connection, a tunnel is also a relatively inexpensive connection because it uses the internet as its primary form of communication. Alternatives to creating a tunnel are acquiring a dial-up telephone line or leasing a telephone line, both of which can be more expensive. Now that we have an understanding of the protocols that enable the internet to function, let us take a closer look at the www, the area of the internet most familiar to all of us, the World Wide Web. WWW is a vast collection of electronic documents that are located in many different web servers and contains text, images, and more, videos and more, that can be accessed by simply clicking links within a browser's web page. Using web browser, you can download and view web pages. The web pages are created using HTML, all right, which can be generated manually with text-based editors such as Notepad through the use of web page authoring tool. A web page authoring tool is similar to word processor, except instead of creating text document, you create HTML-based web pages. The web page authoring tool has a graphical user interface that allows you to enter text and insert graphics. HTTP. Once you have created a web page, you can store it in a computer that contains web server. All right, so this is called HTTP protocol. The Hypertext Transfer Protocol, HTTP protocol, is an application layer protocol, as was explained in Chapter 1. When the user sitting at the workstation running a browser, a click on a link, the browser software seeks this click and creates an application layer HTTP command, retrieve the web page. This HTTP command passes through the transport layer, network access layer, before it applies to the network medium. When the web page request is received at the website server, the web page is retrieved and returned across the internet to the user's browser, where it is displayed on the monitor. Details. The entire purpose of HTTP is to send and receive web pages. To accomplish this operation, HTTP can perform a number of different commands called methods. A few of the more common methods are the following: get, retrieve a particular web page; head, uses a given URL to receive only HTTP header; put, so we have get, head for header; put, sends data from user's browser to remote. So these are the methods: delete, request the server delete information that corresponds to your locating a document on the internet; uniform resource locator, URL. In order for the user to be able to find something on the internet, every object located on the internet must have a unique address. This address, or uniform resource locator, uniquely identifies files, web pages, images, or any other type of electronic documents that resides on the internet. When you are using a web browser and you click a link to a web page, you are actually sending a command out to the internet to fetch the particular web page for a specific location that is based on the URL. The parts of URL for HTTP and FTP. So the first part, HTTP, this is the FTP. The second part is here. Third and the rest. First part, second part. All right. All URLs consist of four parts, as shown in this figure that we just saw, like this figure here, 10.9. The first part is indicated by 1 in the figure, is the service type, either HTTP service or FTP service. Identifies the protocol that is used to transform the requested document. Other service types include Telnet. You can type Telnet in the browser instead of HTTP. You can type FTP, as shown here. You can type news to access to Usenet group. You can type mail to send an email message. This is really nice. Okay. The second part of the URL indicated by 2 in this figure is the domain name. So this is the domain here. This is the domain. Oops. Here's the domain here. And here's the domain here. This portion of URL identifies a particular server at a particular site that contains the requested items. In this example, figure 10.9, this domain is one of the servers supporting the computer science department in the DePaul University. So they are making an advertisement for the university inside the textbook. That's nice. Starting on the right, EDU at the top level domain indicates the web server is an educational site. Some other top level domains are .com for commercial, .gov for government, .mil for military, .org for non-profit organization, .net for network-based, .biz for business, name, info, pro, museum, aero, coop, whatever. Each country also has its own top-level domain name. For example, Canada, CA, UK is UK, a number of years ago. The Intranet Assigned Numbers Authority, the organization responsible for the main for maintaining top-level domain, opened further the possible choices for the top-level domain names. For example, we now have domain names such as museums and graphics. The domain name in the next at the next level called mid-level name. It's usually the name of the organization, often a company or school or host, such as DePaul. All right, so we are seeing this is the commercial, this is the name of the organization, this is the commercial, this is the name of the organization, right? Any other lower level domains are further subdivision of the host and are usually created by the host. For example, we support a company named FiberLock, apply to the agency handling domain name, registering to ask the mid-level FiberLock, because FiberLock is a commercial business, its top level will be .com. If no one else using FiberLock, the company granted FiberLock.com. As its domain, the company may add more domain levels such as www or email, or create entities such as this or this, which could correspond to the company's web page server and email server respectively. The third part of the URL labeled three, the third part here. Is the directory or the subdirectory information. For example, the URL, this, the ADA, it specifies that the requested item, it specifies that full URL specifies that the requested item is located in subdirectory ADA. Under subdirectory utilities, under the subdirectory public. The final part of the URL specified by the number four is the file name. All right. And that can be HTM. If no file name were specified in the URL, then default files such as default.htm or index.html would be retrieved. All right. DNS, domain name system. All connections to the internet are defined by either 32-bit binary IPv4 or 128 binary IPv6. Asking a user, so it's either by 4 bytes or 4 by 4, 12 bytes, right? Asking a user to enter 32-bit address into a web browser would be cruel and unusual punishment. Can you imagine trying to enter 32-128-bit address? Even the dotted decimal notation for the IPv4 address and the hexadecimal form of IPv6 address are not convenient for most humans. When referencing an internet site, we often refer to domain name computers. However, do not use domain names because computers use binary. Computers, however, do not use domain names because computers use binary addresses, and almost all humans begin use the domain name form. The internet converts the binary forms into English-based domain names and vice versa. To do this, it uses the domain name DNS, which is a large distributed database of the internet addresses and domain names. So it's a big database of the IPs and the domain names. And here are some details. Internet services, one of them is the email. Most messages consist of plain text, are written simple ASCII characters. What if you want to send or attach non-text items such as spreadsheet, database? The email program then creates a multi-purpose internet mail extensions, MIME, document, and attaches it to the mail message. Once the email and the optional attachment have created, it is time to transmit the message. The extended SMTP is an internet protocol for sending and receiving emails. It is used to perform the transfer. To send an email message, the source computer establishes a TCP connection to port 25, typically on the destination computer. The destination computer has an email daemon, a program that always running in the background and waiting to perform a function that supports ESMTP protocol. The email daemon watches port 25, accepts incoming connections, and copies messages to the appropriate mailbox. The European and Canadian equivalent to this ESMTP is the X.400 protocol. Interesting. So the European here, for the first time, they mentioned something about European standard. Okay. Which means we were talking only about American stuff. Okay. How many times do you receive an email message even though your machine is not turned on? When you turn on your computer and run your email program, a message informs you that you have N new email messages waiting. When this, what software performs this operation? POP3 is the software that allows a user to save email addresses in a server mailbox and download them when desired from the server. POP3 is useful if you do not have a permanent connection to the network and must connect using temporary internet connection. POP3 will hold your email messages until your next time dial and access the mailbox. Thus, POP3 software is commonly found on mobile laptop computers or home computers without permanent network connections, but also on computer systems that have a permanent connection. An alternative to POP3 is the most sophisticated IMAP. IMAP is the latest version of IMAP. The latest version of it is IMAP 4, is a client-server protocol in which email is received and held for you at your internet server. You can view just heading of the email, view the sender of the email, then decide if you want to download the email. You can also create and manipulate folders or mailboxes on the server, delete old emails, and or search part of the email message. Many email packages allow a user to encrypt an email message for secure transfer over the internal local area network or over the wide area network, such as the internet. When an email message is encrypted, it's virtually impossible to intercept and decode. the message without the proper encryption algorithm and key. Important email messages can also have a digital signature applied to that. In the future, the owner of an email message can prove that the email message belongs to no one but him or her. Encryption techniques will be discussed later in Chapter 12. FTP, the File Transfer Protocol, was one of the first services offered on the internet. Its primary function are to allow a user to download a file from a remote site to the user's computer and to upload file from user's computer to a remote site. These files contains data such as numbers, text, or images executable, among other. Although www has become the major vehicle for retrieving text, image, and basic, many organizations still find useful to create FTP repository of data and program files using web browsers or specialized FTP software. You can easily access FTP site. If you desire privacy and wish to restrict access to FTP site, this site can be designed to acquire user ID and password for entry. How the MIME system works. Five different MIME types. Header provides, and here the it shows that. Remote login or telnet. Telnet is a terminal emulation program for TCP/IP network, such as the internet, that allows users to log in to remote computers. Telnet. The Telnet program runs on your computer and connects your workstation to a remote server on the internet. Once you are connected to the remote server or host, you can enter commands through the Telnet protocol, and those commands will be executed as if you are entering them directly at the terminal of the remote computer. There are a number of reasons of using Telnet programs. First, Telnet allows a user to log in to personal account and execute the programs no matter where he or she. For example, you might have a computer account at two different companies or different schools, although you may be physically located at one site. You can use Telnet to log on to other computer site. Through this logon, you can check your email or run application. Second, remote login allows users to access public service on a remote computer site. Third, Telnet enables a network administrator to control a network server and communicate with the other servers on the network. This control can be performed from a remote distance, such as another city or remote administration. Telnet has been a drop in use in the last decade or so. One more popular that replaced it is the remote desktop connection offered by Microsoft and called RD Desktop at Unix and Linux systems. Remote desktop. All right, so remote desktop connection in Windows and R desktop in Unix. And R desktop, these are websites, these are, I'm not sure if I have it here, anyhow. Voice over IP. A popular service that has attracted the interest of companies and home users alike is the sending of voice signals over an IP-based network such as the internet. The practice of making telephone calls over the internet had a number of different names, including packet voice, voice over packet, voice over the internet, internet telephony, and voice over IP. So they are all the same. But it appears that the industry has settled on the term voice over IP in reference to the internet protocol, which controls the transfer of data over the internet. There are currently three ways to deliver voice over IP to users. The first technique is found at the corporate level. Many companies are offering voice over IP that operate over a local area network. These systems involve a fair amount of equipment, such as voice over IP servers, special IP-enabled telephones, routers that can direct telephone calls. Today, a large portion of corporate sites have converted their older internal telephone system to voice over IP system that operates over LAN. Thus converging two systems into one. A second common solution is the one often encountered at home. Using existing telephones, a special converter is added between the telephone and the high-speed internet DSL connection. The converter digitizes the voice and creates a stream of packets, then sends it over to the IP connection. The third connection involves smartphones. Newer cell phone technologies are all packet-based, thus requiring telephone calls to be converted to digital packets and sending those packets over the IP address. When a reliable and high-quality telephone system is already available, why explore an alternative technology that provides the same voice? One of the earlier advantages of the IP was simply related to the fact that long-distance calls, especially overseas calls, are expensive. All right, then we talk about voice over IP and private voice over IP systems. All right, then we talk about voice over IP gateway. Then we have the session initiation protocol. And we have the Enum is a protocol that converts telephone numbers to fully qualified domain name addresses. So Enum converts the telephone numbers into IP addresses, domain addresses. And we have finally, while not exactly the same as voice over IP, voice over wireless LAN is very similar. Instead of transmitting a voice over wired IP address, voice over WLAN allows user to roam within the building or the campus while using a wireless headset, wireless communicate with more people using wireless LAN. All right. List serves is a popular software program used to create and manage internet mailing lists. List serve software maintains a table of email addresses and reflects the current member of the list serve. When an individual sends an email to a listserv address, the listserv sends a copy of this email address to every email address stored in the listserv table. Thus, every member in the listserv receives the email message. Other names for listservs or other types of listserv software include MailServ, Major, Domo, Almanac. Other names for listserv or other types of listservs software includes this. Streaming audio and video, real-time protocol, real-time streaming protocol, instant messages, tweets and blogs.